Hi friends, how are you? In this video clip, I am going to brief you on the spinning. Please subscribe to my channel. I'm like it and share it. Thank you very much. Already I covered one topic on blue room line. This is the second part or second topic, that is the second stage of the card preparatory department. What preparatory? Preparatory process of spinning department. In my first part, blue room line, you can watch, visit my channel. Please subscribe to my channel, share it and like it. This video is I am considering as a lecturer. I am not going to edit anymore, but you can see the captions or subtitles. Here it's coming, here it is there. If you are not understanding my language, okay, please click the icon bell for the next notifications. Okay, I'm very much thankful to all my subscribers who are supporting to meet the 1,000 subscribers by my first achievement. Okay, then this video, what I'm going to say is carding department. What is carding department? Carding is one of the department of ring spinning mill, that is conventional spinning mill. That is conventional spinning mills, not only for cotton, even polyester viscose or polyester cotton, any staple fiber processing to manufacture yarn. That is ring spinning mill, ring spinning process. You know ring spinning process? There are stages, that is preparatory stages, mixing department, blow room department, carding, drawing, combing, and simplex, and ring frame and binding. Carding department is the heart of the spinning industry, that is conventional spinning industry. Not conventional, now technology is updated, modernization is taken place in the textile industries. But what I am discussing or briefing here is about the conventional carding machines, carding process. In my first video blue room line, what I discussed, that is the mixed 3 or 4 varieties of cottons are mixed homogeneously and fed to the blue room line, and it is subjected to the beater, opening, cleaning and that lab formations. In conventional spinning mill, in olden or conventional spinning mills, the lap is formed, that lap is transferred or moved to the carding department. But still developed the mill, that is chute feeding. In chute feeding, whatever the reduced tuft or cleaned dust and dirt, foreign metal, whatever the cleaned cotton is there, that directly feed to the carding machines uniformly. That is called chute feeding. That is everything flowing of the cotton takes place by the help of blow of cotton through the air, suction air through the hose pipes. Okay, whatever the means, whether that is a lap formation, whether that is a chute feeding, anyway the cotton is feeding to the carding machines. See, in carding department there is a calculation is there. For particular ring frame running in the spinning division, how many spinning frames, whether 864 spindles, 564 spindles, 1080s, whatever the number of spindles or whatever the spindle capacity of the machines of the mill, based on that carding machines are worked. For particular count, for particular fineness, whether it is carded or combed, what type of cotton count is going on, based on that carding machines, the continuous flow of raw material is required. Based on that calculation, based on number of ring frame, the number of simplex are decided based on number of simplex, number of drawing machines, number of combing machines, like that number of carding machines are decided, and also number of blurring lines also are required. That is not enough, but carding machines, say usually around 20 to 25 normal 21,000 spindle capacity mill is usually keeping around 20 to 25 even 30 carding machines they will run. Suppose that mill is running around 4 to 5 counts in 24 hours 3 shifts. And the thing is, suppose this is a calculation there, suppose 4 carding machines are required to run one drawing frame. What is the drawing frame? The raw material fed to the drawing frame usually require 8 draw cans. Carding cans is required. To run one drawing frame, 8 drawing cans regularly, continuously need to fed. 8 carding machines will feed one drawing machines usually. Usually in olden days, even 6 carding cans carding cans were enough. But usually normal textile mills will require 8 carding machines to run one draw frame. Okay, I'm considering whatever 8 or 12 or 4, whatever it is there. Now, carding is the heart of the spinning machine. Why every author is saying carding is a heart of the spinning mill? Because whatever in carding, what process is going on? All whatever the cotton, small tuft of the cotton is, becomes free from each other, make it free from each other. And whatever the remaining dust and dirt for material is there, that is separated. And each and every individual fibers are separated. And also the separated individual fibers are combed by the cylinder. Combed by the carding feeder and cylinder and doffer, whatever is there in the machines. Okay. So that whatever the incoming, that raw material fed to the carding machine is in the form of lap. That lap is containing not a freed fibers, but it is an entanglement of or lumps of, that is small balls of fibers which are entangled each other, hold each other, that is freed in the carding machines. And whatever the dust and dirt and foreign metals are hold between the fibers, that is fallen down. And all individual fibers which are freed and which are combed and make them parallel, fibers are paralyzed, all paralyzed, then. And whatever the outcome of the carding machine is there, the outcome of carding machines is like a web. It is a web. It is sheet form. Sheet of what? Sheet of cotton. You know, non-wovens. Non-wovens is also required carding machines. How the non-wovens? Now you are using mask. Whatever the bags are there, carry bags are there, whatever is there, non-wovens, made of non-wovens. Non-woven products are required special carding machines. In carding machines, the raw tuft fibers is freed, and whatever web is coming in the form of thin layer, 1 mm layer, and even 1 mm layer of web is coming throughout the width of the cotton, and finally it is condensed in a condenser roller and passed into the revolving mechanism to fill it in the carding cans. That is winding of the sliver staple. Whatever the web is converted into the rope form, that rope form is called the carding sliver. Okay, now this carding sliver is revolved, packaging of carding sliver is done by revolving mechanisms. Okay, this is the process. Okay, how much percentage of cleaning dust and dirt freed from the fibers, how much percentage of the fibers are gets paralyzed, how much percentage of fibers are paralyzed, freed, individualized, that is called efficiency of the carding machines. and how much in 8-hour shift, how many times the carding machine stops because of the breaking takes place, because of the feed is waiting for the feeding of the labs, waiting for the cotton back from the blow room, because of the sliver breaks, because of the maintenance problems, because of the machine problems, in 8 hours, okay, how much is required? The total efficiency of the carding machine, okay, gives the quality, how much good quality sliver it will give, how much dust free sliver it will give, how much production it will give per 8 hours. These are all required to judge the final yarn quality and final fabric quality. Okay, that is why this carding machine is called, what called, heart of the spinning machine. 50% of the spinning taken place in the carding machine only. Whatever the further processes are there, that is reduction in the diameter of the carding sliver into roving into what, yarn, 20s count, 24 count, 30s count, 40s count, 100 count, 120s count, 180 count. Whatever these counts I am saying, that is the reduction in the diameter of the what, carding sliver. 50% of the spinning taken place in carding, because raw cotton is converted into a rope form in carding only, not in drawing, not in combing, not in simplex. Only in drawing, combing, simplex, what are there, only drafting, twisting, winding, drafting, twisting, winding, this process will only be there for that. So this is very, very important department of the carding department. Okay, next I will come to the other point of the carding machine. I told the efficiency of the carding machines. Efficiency of the carding machines, if the feeding stops to the draw frame because of the carding slivers are not there, because of the carding machine stopped, breakdowns are there, then continuous further stoppage will be there, production loss will be there. And if the carding machine stops because of the maintenance, because of the electricity, because of the mechanical, because of the labor inefficiency, not attending the carding machine properly, it will take, breakdown will be there. So what I am saying, and also other than this, more important cause root for the breakdown of the carding machines, to failure of the carding machines, is the humidity control of the carding department. Humidity in spinning mill, in cotton spinning mill, humidity is very, very important, especially for carding machines. In carding machines, if the relative humidity, that is the difference between dry weight and wet, dry bulb and wet bulb, okay, that difference, 65% of relative humidity, 21 to 23 degrees centigrade of temperature is required in carding machines, plus or minus will be there. Okay, if the humidity is not proper, if the environment of the department environment is gets dried, then web is not coming properly, sticking of the web takes place, or choking in the coiler will be there, or heat of the fibers there, sometimes fire will take place in the machines. Fire is a common cause root in the textile mill. Okay, fire, it will there then. If temperature, not humidity, is not controlled, if it is not the moist, whatever the moist is there in the department, if it is not proper, chances of fire takes place in the carding, chances of electrical fire will takes place in the carding, chances of web choking or coiler choking is possible. Okay, these are the things are there. So in carding department, the supervisor, the carding floor peoples, whether the labor or the supervisor or production, whoever there, first they have to concentrate on the humidity of the carding machines. Okay, this is one. And third point I am coming to discuss on the, about the carding machine is modernization. Modernization the carding machines. Now you see already in 25 to 50 years old machines, Lakshmi Reeder, the brand, in if I talk about the India, Lakshmi Reeder is a brand running, and now after that Reeder, Rustler, nowadays so many brands are there. Okay, especially European, Germany brand, everything will be there. Many high technology, modern technology, Rustlers, okay, and Reeders will be there. Okay, so many development brands are there, technically, highly technical. In this modernized machines, each and every process is controlled electronically. Whether the aim of the adopting software in the carding machines or microprocessor, use of microprocessor or auto leveler, auto stoppler, auto stopping, whatever is there system, that is software system, everything is there, that is only to avoid the breakages or to avoid machine stoppages or to increase the efficiency of the carding machines. Okay, so here I am stopping this department, carding department. Next topic I will come for the drawing department. Okay, and after drawing, combing, after combing, simplex, then ring frame, one by one come. Already I released, you know, lecture on blur room. This is not, I am not editing this video, only I am releasing as a lecturer on carding department. Okay, please subscribe to my channel. I'm like it and share it. Thank you very much.